My name is EposVox, and today I'll be discussing the stream command capabilities of Elgato Game Capture HD software. I will have other tutorials on Elgato's capture cards and a plethora of other technology topics on my channel, so be sure to subscribe if you find this video helpful, and check the YouTube card icon above or the description below for a playlist with my other Elgato gaming-related videos. Stream command is Elgato's answer to popular major broadcasting software. It takes the basic recording functionality to pair with the Game Capture HD hardware and greatly expands it to give you a full streaming and recording platform with multiple tracks, on-screen overlays, face cam, and more. Let's take a look at setting that up. If you've ever used streaming software like Open Broadcaster Software, XSplit, or Wirecast, the stream command interface should feel familiar. If not, let's look deeper. It's also worth noting that using stream command requires a decently powerful computer. Quad-core or higher processors, 8GB or more of RAM, and a mid to high-end level graphics card are strongly recommended. High-level broadcasting is an intense process and not for the lower-end laptop users among you. Just like with flashback recording, you first need to make sure that stream command is enabled in your software. Click the gear icon in the top right-hand corner of the software and check the box next to Enable Stream Command and hit OK. This may reset your flashback recording buffer and take a moment to reload your stream. Not much changes here, other than the addition of the stream command bar above normal recording tools. This presents you with a row of pre-made scenes to choose from, along with the scene editor. This is where the fun happens. Scenes are just like they sound, a scene. Think of a play. You have similar components. You've got your setting, your gameplay, the actor, you via live commentary and or face cam, and a various side or background elements such as overlays, follower alerts, and other graphics. These components are called sources, and they compose the scene. Upon activating stream command, you're given a set of pre-configured scenes that are mostly ready to use. Provide gameplay and a webcam, and you're good to go. By clicking Edit Scenes and then clicking the Add Scene button, signified by a small plus inside a box, you can create your own scenes or download more preset ones with game-specific overlays and themes to try out. Besides gameplay and your vocal commentary, by editing a scene you can add various different sources to make your content more exciting. Let's look at all the available stream command sources you can add by building a new scene. Starting from the top, curated scenes let you add professionally designed overlays for free. For those who need inspiration for an overlay or want to start streaming in mere minutes without much setup, these overlays are perfect. You can see it also automatically adds a webcam and places it in the frame if you want. Let's delete that and build a new scene from scratch. To start, let's add an overlay graphic by clicking Add Image. You can position, resize, crop, etc. Next, I'll add my webcam. These settings here let you access the advanced features like chroma keying if you have a green screen. Next, I'll add some text to bring in my social media links. You can also use this in combination with free tools to place now playing overlays, for example. Finally, I'm going to add a web page source. Why would you add a web page to your stream? For alerts, of course. While there still isn't a worthwhile setup for YouTube gaming streaming yet, a staple to popular Twitch live streams is having an alert of new followers, donators, hosts, etc. show up on stream. This is typically done through a service like Streamlabs, previously called Twitch Alerts. On the Streamlabs website, you connect your Twitch account, then you create your own alert box widget. You can customize background colors, icons, sound effects, and so on. Then simply copy the widget URL, edit a scene in Game Capture HD software, click Add a web page, and paste the URL in the address bar. If you have a specific layout you're working with, you can customize the resolution of the alert box. Otherwise, automatic will work just fine. Save your scene, and you now have follower alerts engaged directly into your Elgato livestream. And again, while you're editing your scene here, you'll notice you have a healthy set of tools to customize all of your sources on your livestream. You can move elements around, resize them, crop them, add chroma keys, and so much more. Tweak it just the way you like it and hit save. With most Elgato capture cards, you also have the ability to save a master copy of the recording without the stream command overlays. We'll cover this in a separate video. So that's it for this video. This was a rather lengthy tutorial, but we covered pretty much everything you need to know to use the stream command to make a great live stream. I hope this video has been helpful for you. If it has, go Crash Bandicoot belly flop on that like button, get subscribed for more awesome tech videos, and check out the description below. There, I have a link to the playlist with all of my Elgato gaming tutorials and reviews. Check them out. I also have product links to each Elgato card if you're looking to buy. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.